On the public hearings. Time for consideration of an ordinance to rezone 6.70 acres from planned mixed-use development to primarily commercial by Quick Trip Corporation. The property is located at 1394 North St. Augustine Road. The Greater Lowndes Planning Commission reviewed this request at their November regular meeting and recommended approval of 8-0. Council postponed this request at the 7th regular meeting until tonight. Matt Martin, now explain what's going on here.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mayor. This is a rezoning request. By Quick Trip Corporation for nearly 7 acres of land. PMD zoning stands for planned mixed-use development. This is an old zoning category from many years ago. As indicated by the age of the zoning change, which was almost 13 years ago, 2007. It was a very large mixed-use plan development that was approved. And it consisted primarily of commercial uses with a few offices and residential. A copy of that master plan is in your packet. The way plan developments were done back then, it was a zoning change, which meant the deviation from the approved master plan would require a rezoning hearing. And because the applicants were proposing a travel center, both automobile and truck fuel pumps, that is not part of that master plan from 2007, they have to rezone the property. So the request is to rezone from PMD to highway commercial CH, as shown as the CH on the red on the zoning map. As you see, it fits in very well with the other CH zoning in Exit 18. Comprehensive plan, this is a future development map. It assigns a character area of regional activity center to the Exit 18 area. That is one of our more intensive character areas. As you can imagine, Exit 18 being fairly dense with urban development. CH zoning is complied with that, so that checks the box there. Aerial imagery, this is from a couple years ago. Most of this PMD property is still wooded. This is land between James Circle and James Road. It is also directly to the east of the Raceway fuel station and next to a cluster of some hotels right by the interchange. And they're proposing a site plan. This is a conceptual plan that shows the fuel pumps for the automobiles and fuel canopy for trucks in the back. There's been some question as to how the final design of this might take place. It still is to be determined if the project is rezoned, but still have to go through the full grant review process. You may recall from the December meeting, we had to table this for a development regional impact review as mandated by the state. It's completed, and the city now has the green light to proceed with the rezoning request. With that, the Planning Commission reviewed this at their meeting on November the 25th. They found it consistent with the comprehensive plan and the standards for exercise and zoning power. And all of those are outlined there in your packet, and they are recommending approval of the two. I'd answer more questions you may have. We talked about it a good bit in the work session.
No questions, Council? Would anybody like to speak in favor of this request that is in the audience? Please state your name and approach the line.
Good afternoon, Mayor, Council members, Bill Nigel, House of 7th Patterson Street. I'm here on behalf of Wojo. First, I want to say congratulations to the mayor on the election and congratulations on all the council members who are here. Again, this is really just sort of cleaning up the remnants of a plan development that never came to fruition. We have this track between James Road and James Circle. State Road 133, CH all around it. So we're asking to take this If you've been through Metro Atlanta or Georgia, you've probably stopped at Quick Trip. They have 800 locations in 11 states, 136 stores in Georgia itself, and 20 counties in Georgia. So we really believe this will be a good corporate citizen for Valdosta and Lowndes County. It's a company with a long track record that's been very successful with what they do. There will be approximately 45 to 50 employees at the store alone. If you read the DRI report from the Southern Georgia Regional Commission, they stated in there that this store alone will generate between $100,000 and $200,000 a year in local taxes. So that has to be noted as well. The site plan here, that is in y'all's report. Elevations, as I stated right here, we recommend that you approve the property for rezoning and follow the recommendations of the Planning Commission, the Southern Georgia Regional Commission, and staff. And I'm here to answer any questions you may have. Mike Barton is also here with Quick Trip. He made a trip down to Atlanta, and so if I can answer them, but for my opinion.
Council, any questions?
Question, but I would love you to let the party to send it to you as it is.
Would you flip the displays?
And then these are pictures of the canopies.
General manager, store manager, assistant manager.
Our starting pay
tuition reimbursement program is the employee would apply to college for undergraduate degree. What they do there is they pay for their tuition up front, and then after the semester's over, they submit their transcript and their grades, and then we go up to a cap. It was $2,000 when I was a student, which has probably gone up since then, it's been a while. And then we request a check back.
Sounds like a great company. I'll let you two exchange business cards for any further questions. Thank you, that's very much. Nobody else speaking in favor? Is there anybody that wants to speak in opposition of this rezoning request? Please come to the microphone and state your name.
Mayor, Councilman, I'm Anthony Cody. Question, I can, this quick trip that I stopped to, they are very clean, well kept up, but my question to you, I know of Atlanta, they lack of security up there because they're on that two side. They had problems with vandalism and all that, people come out, parking cars leaving, parking trucks leaving. You already have limited space. What are you going to do for that? Before trying to cut all that out, before bringing all that excess in there. When you start bringing in and then dropping counters and all this, and then better stay there, it creates some rust.
Sure, I'm happy to address that. Between my time in stores, before coming over into real estate, I actually worked in our security department. All of our stores were sent to monitor our security desk and also 24-hour security. I don't typically bring along a security plan, but what we do is we cover every square inch of our properties with high-definition video cameras. That's outside as well as inside. Inside we're covering high-definition security cameras as well as audio. So our security desk can hear what's going on in the store and see what's going on in the store. If there is an event, the employee has a bell alarm as well as an alarm positioned throughout the store. Our older security system had a reaction time of about 4 minutes. Our new security system is here instantaneous. It's IP based, goes back to a room about the size of this room, kind of looks like Laura, a bunch of computer screens up on the wall, alarms go off, and it's flashing up on the screen. You'll notice here that our parking stalls are fairly limited. We're doing that because chargers like to park. We're not really a big fan of them parking. We'd rather them get their stuff and move on. As you know, there's plenty of other land behind this property. We have the opportunity to buy the rest of the land if we wanted to put additional parking, but it's just not part of the business model anymore. So those are the kinds of things that we do. Make sure our sites are well lit, those kinds of things.
All right, no more questions, but is there anybody else that wants to speak out against the zoning request? No more, state your name.
Semi-trucks that are coming off the interstate, and there's barely
enough room where you turn off of exit 18 and turn on to St. Augustine, you have to immediately turn back left. And their site plan has two major accesses into the property that's on a two-lane road. Just down the street where there is no red light, there's four-lane and James Road. So my concern tonight is not to stop Quick Trip from coming to Valdosta. I think they have a great organization. We welcome them as a business partner in the community. But I would ask that you consider, when you look at this site plan, what it's going to cost. In their proposal, I had a fortunate opportunity to read from Mr. Martin's office. Some of the things that are in their proposal are not correct based on the traffic flow. And the traffic flow, if they come in on the James Circle, there's going to be a problem for the businesses that are there, and it's going to be a problem. We have a school that's just down the street. And you talking about putting 18 wheelers, it's just going to be a concern. So I ask you, please, you know, when you look at this and make a decision, that you make a decision based on not what's just good for business community and all of us, but also what's happening with safety, which is one of the most important considerations.
Ricky, thank you very much.
Thank
you. All right, people, address that.
Yeah, this shows real quick all of your points very, very well. Appreciate it, and then we'll take it here. I know their council is just addressing the rezoning. Yeah. All those points that you just made, we addressed at that point in time.
So yes, sir.
Thank you very much.
Anyone speaking out of opposition? I'll now turn it over to council for action.
Mayor, I would like to make a motion to